We are keeping this session, right? So it is about exam time fear, anxiety, और बहुत कुछ गुजरना पड़ता है एग्जाम से पहले आप सभी को, ठीक है? और इसलिए हम ये सेशन रखा हुआ है, और ये देखने के लिए कि एक बार आपकी आवाज सुने और फिर उसको हम कैसे हैंडल कर सकते हैं, क्या क्या तरीका होगा आपके लिए जो आपके लिए बहुत फ्रूटफुल हो, और आगे के 1.5 महीने का जो टाइम बचा हुआ है, या फिर टू बी प्रिसाइज करीब करीब 35 दिन बचे हुए हैं, वो आप ढंग से तैयारी भी कर सको और बहुत खुश होकर एंजॉय भी कर सको, राइट? सो दिस इज हाउ द सेशन इज गोइंग टू बी, एंड टू स्टार्ट विथ आई एम ओपन टू लिसन टू ऑल योर क्वेश्चंस, इफ एट ऑल वॉट एवर क्वेश्चन यू हैव, एंड वी विल कैरी फॉरवर्ड अवर डिस्कशन इन द सेम डायरेक्शन. So you can speak out your questions and one by one I will answer all that thing. Chat में type कर दो या फिर अपने questions यदि आप बोल नहीं पा रहे हो तो, okay? I will read it out and answer your questions. And this is going to be an extraordinary session for all of you, okay? And you are going to get extreme value. आपने जो preparation करी है उसके ऊपर भी यू नीड समथिंग, यू नो, एंड दिस इज दिस सेशन इज ऑल अबाउट. सो यू कैन टाइप योर क्वेश्चंस, यू कैन स्पीक आउट व्हाट एवर यू विश टू. चैट इज ओपन नाउ. सो हाउ टू ओवरकम फियर ऑफ फेलर. ओके, तो फियर ऑफ फेलर है क्यों आपको, ये बताओ पहले. तो आप यू कांट से दैट कि विकास सर व्हाट विल आई से, बस है फियर ऑफ फेलर. सो आई टेल यू, फियर ऑफ फेलर ना इज कमिंग जस्ट बिकॉज यू हैव सम कंफ्यूजन अबाउट योर सेल्फ. आपको आपकी कैपेबिलिटी के बारे में संदेह है, डाउट है, यू हैव अ डाउट अबाउट योर सेल्फ, एंड दैट इज वॉट इज क्रिएटिंग फियर. ओके, और ये डाउट जो है वो इसलिए नहीं है कि आपकी प्रिपरेशन नहीं है, ये इसलिए नहीं है बिल्कुल भी. ये डाउट इसलिए है क्योंकि आपको लगता है ऐसा कि शायद आपकी प्रिपरेशन नहीं है. ऑलराइट, सो वन थिंग आई वांट टू से दैट फ्रॉम नाउ ऑनवर्ड व्हेनेवर यू लिसन कि नो आई एम बीइंग फियरफुल, आई हैव अ फियर ऑफ फेलर, आई हैव अ आई डोंट नो हाउ द एग्जाम विल गो, माय इनविटेशन वुड बी जस्ट लिसन टू इट एंड इग्नोर इट. आपके साथ इफ यू आर गोइंग ऑन अ स्ट्रीट और देर आर पीपल हु आर सेइंग समथिंग अबाउट यू, सम मैड पीपल और हुएवर, सो व्हाट यू डू, यू जस्ट इग्नोर एंड मूव ऑन, राइट? सो माय इनविटेशन वुड बी जस्ट डोंट इंटरटेन दोज थॉट्स. वो आएंगी बार बार आएंगी बार बार आएंगी बार बार आएंगी, और उस थॉट को इग्नोर करने का क्या तरीका है, व्हाट इज द वे आउट टू इग्नोर दोज थॉट्स, आई विल कम इनटू दैट पार्ट एज वेल. As we move forward, there are certain steps I will tell you which will help you to get rid of that. But to start with, it is you who is required not to entertain any such thoughts. All right. So let's move on to the second question for now. I got it. So I will be mostly in English. Don't worry. Anyone else? Any questions? You can type, you can speak out, whatever you wish to.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Yes, sir. I have a question. Sir, sometimes it happens like 1 month before the prelims exam, like we are doing a lot of questions, practice and everything, but suddenly there is something that comes up, like before going to sleep you see some other material or some other question and you can't attempt it, like from some other institute, and then you feel that I have prepared nothing.
Hmm.
And that kind of thing comes.
Hmm.
How to deal with that?
Look, the syllabus of IAS, UPSC examination is so vast, right? It is so vast. Like, like I don't know how many books you can write, somebody can write. I don't know how much a coaching institute can cover. Like if somebody will prepare for 10 years, in 10 years he will keep on getting new things. However, the important thing is to really focus on your preparation. Things will distract you, no doubt about it. People will distract you. New study material, new coaching material will keep on distracting you. However, my invitation would be to make yourself strong in the area where you are prepared. So what I was saying, that you will get a lot of material. Look, continuously you will get a lot of material, a lot of tests, lot of stuff basically. My invitation would be don't get into the trap of it. It's a trap. Which will take away your focus, okay? Which will take away your focus. And if your focus will be shifted, then you know the result, what the result would be. So my invitation would be, okay, this material is there, but I am going to focus on what I have prepared. And whatever you prepared now, I am saying that it covers almost 98 to 99% of the things, okay? So you don't have to worry about it. That 1% will not make a difference on this exam. It will not make a huge difference, by the way. Is that clear?
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. So there is an exam stress. Stress is because you are not comfortable, right? Look, as a human being, we are not ready for exams, you know. We don't want somebody to judge and evaluate us. We don't want these exams to judge and evaluate us. But exams are something like they are the part of life, you know. Aap jaise baki kaam karte ho na, it is like kisi se baat karna hai. So you speak very normally. You can speak with them very normally. If you want to speak, read a book, you just open the book and you start reading. My limitation would be like, exam is there, theek hai. That is also a part of life. If you want to play cricket, you can go and play cricket easily without even giving it a thought. However, when you consider that cricket is a work for you or your study is a work for you, then that creates a stress. Then that creates the stress actually. So don't consider that as a stress. Consider it as a love, you know. It is your love. It is your passion. You are really here to contribute by writing this exam, getting cleared as a IAS officer, I don't know for how many lives you are going to impact, right? Always prepare anything from that point, then you will start loving the work. You will start loving the notes. You start loving the coaching classes. And the stress will slowly disappear.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
UPSC syllabus. That syllabus if you read means X other than UPSC, the IAS exam, which exam can we take, sir?
Look, I am not the best judge for those questions, okay? Other than UPSC, I don't know what all exams you can take. However, somebody who is the faculty or who is an administrator or somewhere, they will be able to guide you. Right now, this session is only about, and don't, are you preparing for the UPSC and the IAS examination? Hello, can you listen to me? Alright, so don't focus on anything else. Whatever will come after some time, after UPSC exam will come. You don't have to worry about that. The first milestone is to write UPSC, the prelims examination. That is where the whole focus will be. After that, you will have sufficient time to focus on any other exam. But don't focus on anything else. What is the right age? Look, I can't comment on what is the right age. Okay. people prepare at the age of 22, people also prepare when they just pass out from 12th examination. Some people prepare at the age of 27 or 28 or 30, whoever is having the age limit for it. So there is no age limit. If there would have been an age limit, UPSC exam center would not have allowed the gap, basically. You know, people from this age to this age can attend it. So that is the age. Don't bother about it. All right. So I'm reading the next question. Wonderful question. So how do you want to, how, when you will come to know? So my invitation would be, whenever you will be fully confident about yourself, that's 100% preparation for the UPSC, nothing else. You just need to be 100% confident. Nothing else is required. Nothing else. You will be able to deliver and write the exam and get a great, wonderful marks just by being confident. You don't have to worry about it. Preparation is one thing, but confidence is another thing. You have a 100% or, you know, you have all the knowledge of the world, but you are not confident. It will not give you any result. It will not take you anywhere. If I take some of the examples, even from the field of cricket and anything, maybe Sehwag does not had a very orthodox style of batting, but he has been one of the best cricketers. Doesn't matter. It is entirely up to you how well prepared you are. At the same time, along with it, how confident you are yourself. Thank you. Anyone can, any question related to exams, stress and fear?
Engineer course is better or preparing for IAS is better, sir?
Sorry?
Engineer's course is, career is better or preparing for IAS is better, sir?
Look, you can't say the orange is better than apple, right? Can you say that? Nobody can say that. Everything has its own benefits, and certain things everything lacks as well. Doesn't matter. The important thing is, what is it that you want for yourself? What is it that you want for your life? Where do you want yourself to be utilized 100% or fully? So that is the most important thing. It is not about what is good or what is bad. If my body needs apple, I will have apple. If my body needs or I need orange, I will have that. Doesn't matter. All right. Someone else? You can type the questions. You can speak out the questions. Hello.
Sir, how to frame a good study timetable, sir? For example, the previous day before applying for examination or preparing for the next day, I'm planning for around 8 hours, but my mind is saying, okay, fine, you can do it for 12 hours, 14 hours. But in the reality, I'm just planning 6 to 8 hours. So actually, since I plan for 12 hours and just waiting for 6 hours, it gives me anxiety, stress, and depression a lot. So I don't know how to frame a good study plan for a day. So we just
look, as far as the study plan is concerned, I won't be able to answer that question. Like, I will not answer that question because that does not fall into it. However, I can really give you certain things which will help you to take it on. Look, the ideal thing would be, like, you do what really keeps you satisfied and happy. If you think that just before around last 1 week or last 3 days or last 2 days or last 1 day, just if you think that 6 hours is enough, it is enough. Don't follow others. Just do whatever you wish to do. You are the lord for yourself. You are the king for yourself. You know your preparation. don't go flow with, you know, before the exam I will study for 12 hours or 13 hours, or before 1 week of the exam I will study for so many. Of course, it requires a minimum level of preparation before the exams, and that you can do right now. But exactly before the exam, probably you have to choose, like before 1 week, how you want to spend your time, really focusing on recalling whatever you have studied, and rather than going through the new books, new chapters, or something else. Doesn't matter. Is that answers your question?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes. Thanks, sir.
Yeah. So, anyone? Any next questions? Question is not clear to me, so you can retype it again and send it across to me. Okay. Look, you don't have to entertain that conversation, those thoughts. If the selection will not happen, why it will not happen? It will happen. It has to happen. Entertain that conversation. Your entire life is all about not knowing yourself. And my invitation is to power yourself. Power yourself. When I say power yourself, then there are ways to have your own power. And the most important thing which comes when it's all about power is, like, you have to assert to yourself that no matter what, this my profession is absolute, and I'm going to crack it. Say it 100 times. Every hour you say it till the time of the exam, and you will be guided. Don't worry, you will be guided towards that goal. So don't give unnecessary entertainment to those thoughts which are not good for you. Right? Other question right now? You can either raise your hand, you can speak out, you can type. So now I am going to give you something which I want to deliver, okay? And this is extraordinary stuff which will take you through to any exam. It's not only about UPSC, and of course, because you are preparing for the UPSC, it is going to be excellent thing, okay? So there are few things which I have already stated, and now I am going to speak out a few more, okay? So the first. No negative conversation. That is the most important thing. In throughout our life or throughout our preparation, we are always worried, you know. We are always worried about what will happen. Guys, nothing will happen. Don't worry. Okay. Don't entertain those conversations. It does not have that much power, okay. And you have a power. So that is the first thing which you have to really make sure that you do that. Okay. Now I'm writing the second thing. The second is another most important thing. Yeah, so I am saying assert. अपने आप को बोलना है बार बार बोलना है अपने आप कि no matter what, कुछ भी हो जाए, एग्जाम तो क्रैक होगा ही होगा, कुछ भी हो जाए. अभी आप बोल के देखो, म्यूट पे जाके अपने आप से बोल के देखो और एक्सपीरियंस करो इस शक्ति को. experience this power. Just mute the phone, speak to yourself and say, no matter what, I will crack this and see how this power works out for you. This is the one of the most important thing as a aspirant for IAS examination you have to do. The most important thing before anything else. One day got wasted because of one function or one function or because of whatever work you got in the life. Okay, you don't have to worry about that. Everything will keep on bumping on life, you know. It will keep on coming. You never know what will come, when will come, when it will come. However, when you say no matter what, it will happen, so it will happen. All right? Anyone has said to himself? Any experience about it? You can unmute yourself and say. Yeah, now you can unmute. Anyone has practiced just now in this conversation? If not, from now onward, for next 35 days, keep on asserting this. Okay? You just have to assert again and again. Yeah. And the next thing which I have already said, no matter what, I will crack this exam. No matter what. Very simple. कुछ नहीं करना है. कोई negative conversation entertain नहीं करना है. अब you don't have to entertain any negative conversation. You keep on asserting to yourself that no matter what, I will clear this exam. No matter what, कुछ भी हो जाए. And it will remarkably improve your overall preparation as well as the confidence. Remarkably. And if you will start practicing from today itself or from tomorrow itself, if you will start in practicing it from today itself, by tomorrow you will see a different result. By tomorrow, I can give you a bet, like I can give you the promise on it. And this is extraordinary stuff. And you go and write prelims examination, you go and write mains examinations, it will really be extraordinary thing for you. And you can use it anywhere actually. At times it happens, like your father might say something ki Vikas, you might get failed in this exam, and then I say, nahi papa, no dad, don't worry, I will clear it out. And everyone must have had such experiences, right? And then you do it actually, then you clear those exams. So people are there to invalidate you. People are there to invalidate you. They think they can control you. They think that they can influence your preparation. So listen to them, but don't entertain. Listen to them and in the next 2 seconds assert to yourself, no matter what, I will clear this exam. Simple. Smile, give a smile to them. Somebody says, Vikas, you want Google to do it. I go, okay, I got it. Simple. That is a boost for you, you know. It is a boost. When people say to, you will not be able to do it, they are continuously giving you boost. Because you can say to yourself, no matter what, I will clear it. They have not said it, you said it. You gave boost to yourself. And it works the vice versa. When some people say, ki, no, your selection will be through, then sometimes people say, I don't know whether it will happen or not. Don't even, if people say, no, you are through this exam, then I also say, thank you. Simple. You don't need anything else. You don't need anything else. You will be surrounded throughout your life with the people who will have a invalidating conversation with you. It is you who has to entertain it. Don't remember those conversations. They are the same people who are going to congratulate you. You know that? When you will get selected. They are the same people. So why to entertain their current thoughts, their current invalidation? Harun, is that clear? So overthinking is a problem, right? Look, overthinking, I'll not say it is a problem, okay? I won't agree with you it is a problem or not, okay? I will not comment on it. One thing I can say that, look, thinking is never bad, you know. However, my recommendation will be to think only when you are at peace with yourself. When you are silent, when you are in an environment where there is no distractions, then you think about the exam. And that thinking of 15-20 minutes will really guide you your whole day very extraordinarily. Very extraordinarily. But every time while you are eating, while you are asleep, while you are having food, while you are reading, and keep on thinking about the exam, it will not. Though that thinking will not give you those results. So you have to limit your thinking to the time when you are alone, when there is silence in the space. When there is no distraction, when you are with yourself, there is no one around. Is that answers your question? These three steps, nothing else is required. However your preparation is, however, doesn't matter. Doesn't matter however your preparation is. Of course, you need a basic level of preparation for causing anything, okay? But that does not mean that you cannot be a Sahewag, okay? Or you cannot be, Yuvraj Singh for that sake. Of course, everyone want to be Sachin Tendulkar, everyone want to be Dravid, but the other two players were not very orthodox and very methodical and everything, right? They were not. However, they were amazing in their on the field. And you can be the same. And they also did the same thing, you know. Step one, no debating conversation. They kept on asserting to themselves. Kept on saying to themselves, no matter what, I will dash. And they produce extraordinary results. Simple. Very simple. My invitation is next 35 days, spend whenever you get a chance to be with yourself or whenever you get a chance to be in silence, keep asserting to yourself. While you are walking, you can assert yourself. While you are having lunch, you can assert to yourself. While you are standing in front of a mirror, you can assert to yourself. We all go and watch mirror, no? At least 3-4 times in a washroom, we go and watch mirror. You groom your hair. Then also you can say, no matter what, I will clear. And then look the other person, how beautiful he looks. You will have a totally different experience of life. as if you are already selected to the UPSC examination. And I am damn sure, if you have a basic level of preparation even, then you will crack it. You will crack it no matter what. I assert that. Is that clear? So, any next questions? If you go and search for perfection, it is nowhere in the world. Where is perfection? Tell me one thing. There is no perfection. The milk you drink, it is not perfect milk, you know that. The food you eat, it is not perfect. The air you breathe, it is not perfect. The sun rays you get, it is not, that is, even that is not perfect. So why? Why to run behind the perfection? The thought of perfection will keep on coming. I'm not saying that will not come. If you wanted to give a thought about perfection, probably you must have, around 6 months back, you could have thought about it. Or 10 months back, you could have thought about it. But not right now. This is not the right time for being a perfectionist. No, I will let that this time will pass, I will prepare next time, I will prepare perfectly next time. You will never be prepared perfectly. Never. Write it somewhere. No one can be perfect. No one, nothing. So don't go into that inquiry, that conversations, those thoughts. When I am saying this, whatever you are prepared, if you are prepared to a basic level, no matter what, you will crack the exam. What else? The Sehwag or the Yuvraj Singhs or there are a lot of cricketers who are not Rahul Dravid or Sachin Tendulkar. They used to practice every day, that's all. They used to hit the ball nicely, that's all. They may not be conventional in their style, but they know how to hit the ball. They know how to do the exercise for keeping themselves fit. They know how to face a fast bowler or a spin bowler. Doesn't matter if their technique was right or wrong. Doesn't matter. You know when computers started coming, when the computer were made, so earlier it was like the big computers, you know, or the room size computer. And slowly, so around in 1980s, those big size computers were the perfect computers, you know, for the world. They were perfect. Then the desktop started coming and they were perfect. Then the laptop started coming, they were perfect. Then the iPad came, that was also perfect. And something else will also come. So don't go behind the perfection. It will never come. All right? Yeah, you can ask the next question. You can speak, you can write, whatever way. You can unmute yourself and speak out. How to maintain the calmness during the exam hall. So, it's an exact 3 hours time, right? When you have to maintain the calm. Look, again, these three things apply even there. The question paper will come, the questions will start coming to you, and there may be certain questions you may for which you will not have answer to, right? You will not have answer to. Or there may be certain questions which will not be easy for you. So the calmness says, no matter what, this paper is going to be extraordinary, simple. I am going to crack it. And then see how, what comes. Maybe like out of say 100 questions, initial 5 questions, out of 5 questions you only answered 1. But next 5 questions you answered all. The next 5 questions you answered all. And next 5 questions you answered all. You know why? Because you said that. No matter what, I will clear that. don't just be with yourself. You can maintain these structure anywhere, within the hall, before preparation, before one day, before 1 month, before 2 months, doesn't matter. You don't need anything apart from these three. And I'm not denying the preparation part, of course. You need a basic level of preparation. But along with preparation, this is the most important thing which you want. And as a part of Dardani and the team, part of Rahul's team, leading this organization to really entertain all these questions as well as help you out conducting these sessions. We just want your success. We want you to get crowned with a success. And these are some of the points which will help you to achieve that. All right. So that was the first question as well. The confusion. Look, the confusion will be keep coming. You know, it is like somebody asks a question, perfectionist. The confusion will come and say, hey, it is not perfect. Hey, it is not perfect. It is not all right. Or somebody else will come, hey, you have not prepared this section. Hey, this coaching class has given you this material, this new material. Why don't you go and read that? It is awesome or something like that. So the confusion will come. Oh, I have prepared enough. Let me go and check it out. Don't do all that. There is no time for all of it right now. The only time which you have right now is for revision. The fear of failure will come. Continuous distractions. Lekin, you don't have to entertain anything. I am saying with the basic level of preparation and these three things. You are done. Done deal. You have got crowned with the success. And that is our motto. That is what for Dardani is. Okay. So don't confusion, you know. So I come across a lot of books. Like I read a lot of books. I do a lot of stuff in my life, personal life as well. So what is my experience towards failure and confusion? Okay. So wherever there is a confusion, the failure will come alongside. Don't worry. Even if you are 100% prepared, 100%. But if you are in doubt, if you are in confusion, the failure is there. Don't worry. You go and write exam, you will fail. No matter what. How nicely you write exam, doesn't matter. And 99.999999% of the times, wherever there is a confusion and a doubt, the result is a failure. And how the confidence can come? Confidence can come from here. Assertion. Assertion about yourself. Belief about yourself, your preparation. No matter what. I am prepared. Simple. Alright. So, I will take the next question. So negative distractions, okay. So look, distractions will keep on coming. You know, like wherever you are staying, before just before the exam, there might be some casualty in your society, or there might be some fire, or anything can happen. And you may be required to support things. Or people might will come and say, hey, you are not, you don't seem like you are prepared. My invitation is, say thank you and tata bye bye. That's all. Keep on saying thank you to those people. It's all right. Go. Because the number of times you ignore those thoughts or those communication from those people, you get more power. So don't entertain. Somebody will say you are not prepared. Just listen to it. Say thank you. That's all. He got his reply. Just say thank you. not for the thank you for the what he said, thank you for his concern. He's worried about my preparation, but I am confident that I will clear it. That is why I said thank you. So don't get into it. It is going to be the life actually. बहुत लोग मिलेंगे, बहुत लोग बहुत कुछ बोलेंगे, डिस्ट्रेक्शंस होते रहेंगे, घर में डिस्टर्बेंस होएगा, जहां अप्लाई करते हो वहां पर डिस्टर्बेंस होएगा, पावर कट होएगा, यू नो मोबाइल इज अ डिस्ट्रेक्शन, द लाइफ इज फुल ऑफ डिस्ट्रेक्शन. आई एम डिलीवरिंग दिस एंड राइट नाउ लाइक माय फोन इज रिंगिंग, आई डोंट नो हु इज कॉलिंग, आई एम लीस्ट वरीड, यू नो इट्स ऑल राइट, पीपल कैन वेट. What is important to me? The important thing is to have this session be extraordinary for you. And that is my only job. That is what for I am here. So while I will focus on anything else, there may be background noise, there will be disturbance, there will be distraction. Yes, there will be. So don't get into all those distractions. Accept them the way they are. You can't stop the noise of a car, you can't ignore the somebody's music system, you can't ignore some uncertainties which happens. You can't stop, sorry. But you can still ignore and still assert yourself, no matter what. Simple, very simple. And my invitation will be from today onward, go and just practice, just keep on asserting. Keep on asserting. No negative conversation. When I talk about it, it is not only about negative conversation which you have with you, ki how I am prepared, but also the people who, whatever people say to you, doesn't matter. The most important thing is this. The next most important thing is this. This has everything. All right, so I'll take the next question. So keep telling them, don't worry, I will crack it, don't worry. And the if creates a confusion, it creates a doubt. And what is there, the outcome of confusion and a doubt? You know the answer, right? Where it will take you? It will take you to a failure. Even this small line is enough. How can you say to yourself, if I fail to handle? How can? Nobody can, you know. People will say whatever, but you should not. Don't bring any negative conversation about your preparation or anything. Yes, I'm taking the next question. Emotions will keep on coming. So what is good emotion? The emotions which you get from this, or the emotion from which you get from if I fail? Tell me. You can chat, you can write here right now. If I fail, from that you get a good emotions, or you get a good emotion from this? Tell me. And I am sure you will get the good emotions from it. So even your emotions can be controlled by it. This simple lines. There are a lot of people who have really practiced over this session itself. They have practiced it. Whatever I said about this. And they experience the power. They experience the success which is going to come. They experience the crown which is going to come to them. Got it. So why not to follow that rather than if I fail? So, I am going to address the next question. So we were just talking about perfection, right? How can you expect the life to be perfect, by the way? The corona came, everything got like the entire earth became standstill, right? It was not perfect. People were not perfect. Things were not perfect. There was shortage of milk, food items. There are lot of stuff were there, right? Lot of stuff were there. The day got postponed. Sometimes paper also got leaked. What is the most important thing? Is your preparation is dependent on date? No, it should not be. The exam is today or after 1 month or 2 months or 3 months or 6 months, no matter what. I'll crack it, simple. Give me the exam anytime. There will no, now there is no chaos when I say this. Say it to yourself. Say it to yourself, no matter what, I will crack it. Give me any date, we will have it. Then see, you can practice it right now in this session itself. Go on mute and practice it. Alright, so next question, anyone? You can type it, you can type your questions, you can speak out, you can unmute yourself and speak out as well. And this session is going to be a magic. So don't get confused even about asking question. Let it be silly question, doesn't matter. For me, even that question is very precious, you know. We are here to crown you. That is the most important. That is the theme of Diademy. And it's me and my team's entire commitment to get you through to the success. And we will do everything possible for you. Everything possible. Raise your questions, shout out, email us, call us. All right. Look, you have already have all the data for it, right? Last 6 months, it is only COVID, right? You studied it everywhere. You studied it in newspaper. Even today, if you go, you don't need a preparation actually. Go and open any news channel or go and open any magazine. It's all there in the current affairs. And your professors or your teachers has already explained it all. And who knows, before 5th October also something can come, you know. Who knows? Don't try to be perfectionist. It's all right. If you have a basic level of preparation with this, the deal is done. Simple. The deal is done. Alright, so it is almost an hour since we have been interacting. And I'm still waiting for a couple of questions to come, or else we will be wrapping up shortly. So you can, I'm giving you another 2 minutes for you to speak out or type your questions. So anyone want to speak anything or type anything? Or you can, if you want to take a screenshot of this, you can take it if you have not written it already. All right, so here is the next question. All right, so look, consistency is required, no doubt about it. Okay, about anything. And how to be consistent when you talk, okay? So you have to see what is important to you. You don't need to be consistent on the unimportant thing. if there is something which is very important, you have to be consistent. Consistent in the sense like you have to fix up a schedule, simple. And the schedule in which you are most productive. Rest of the schedule, your schedule can vary. But say, like, if you talk about me, I'm most productive between morning 5 and 7. So what I do, if I have to do something, I do at that point of time. That 5 to 7 time is reserved for anything. And that is my consistency. Or sometimes I am more productive between morning 10 to 12. So I keep certain things at that point of time. Today may be important, there is a current affairs which is very important. Okay, I prepared it. Tomorrow I got to know that I have to prepare for economics. So at this point of time, between 10 to 12, I will prepare economics. Simple. You have to be clear, minimum 8 to 9 hours of study or whatever the time works for you. 12 hours, 14 hours, 10 hours, 6 hours, 8 hours, doesn't matter to me. You just keep kept on spending that amount of time. Okay, you keep a target of say 8 hours for yourself. Someday you spend 10 hours, someday 12 hours, someday 14 hours. But minimum at least 8 is maintained. That is consistent. Nothing else is required. All right. I'm taking the next question. Wonderful question. So you take a break and at that point of time, you don't want to look. I'm reiterating your question in my language. Okay. If it is wrong, just type wrong. Okay. So that I will be corrected. So you said, if I take a break, at that point of time, you don't want to be stressed. So my thinking is, when you are taking a break, go and listen to songs, your favorite songs. Go and watch the movies, animal movie or kids movies, which you enjoy. The stress will not come. Look, you have to entertain yourself much more than anything else, okay? If you will not take care of yourself, your happiness, your emotions, then no one else will. All right. Then here is a problem. You watched a movie for 1 hour and now you don't want to study. If that is what you are dealing with, then frankly speaking, it is like you have a child and you say, okay, I will take care of for 4 years, or your father said to you, okay, I will take care of for 4 years and afterwards I will not. Will that be right for you? Never, right? He is there to take care of you forever. Even age of 70, your father is ready to take care of you. So your preparation, your study is not different, okay? It is not different from you. It is your own part. Are you getting what I am trying to tell you? Say yes or no. Remember, what for you are preparing UPSC examination, IAS examination. Why? Just before the study, after the break, you come back and just spend 2 minutes thinking about why you are preparing for it. And then tell me, Vikas sir, it is even after doing that, it is not happening. Your purpose in life is to get selected in IAS and serve the nation, serve the people around you, right? Serve the society, serve the community. So every time you come out of a break, spend 2 minutes or 5 minutes or 10 minutes. Because that is the most important thing, anything which connects you with your dream, with your goal, will make you do the work which you want to do. Got it? Thank you. I'm not going where what mind will say or what mind will not say. Yeah, negative conversation is all about mind. Okay. However, the last thing which I just said, whenever you come from the break, when you are not interested, remember, spend 5 minutes before the preparation on seeing why you are preparing for it. What is it that you are going to gain? What is it that your father, mother, brother, sister or family is going to gain? What is it that you are going to give out of your life to the society or to the nation? That will inspire you again and again to open the book and study, open the notes and study, do the test, whatever you want to do. Good, thank you. So, you have another 2 minutes. I'm keep on extending this time because we have fixed it from 2 to 4 p.m. And we still have time where we can really have an extraordinary conversation. But before that, let me give you something else as well. So, I'm here for next few minutes. However, I'm providing you certain details. Okay. If you want to write and ask those questions to me directly, or if you want to talk to me directly, okay, you can write an email to me, okay, then we will give you a time at what time we can speak, and then I'll give you time to you, okay. So you can write, our email address is this. Is that clear? Or you can, I'm writing it here as well. contact@dadami.com. So you can write to me, and I'll be ready to give you my time. I will not be responding to the emails, by the way. The only thing which will be possible is the call, okay? So because the email takes a lot of time, sometimes the email does not land the way it should be landed to the other person, okay? So the conversation will be far better right now, like in this interactive session also. The conversation has been better, okay? So you can write it, and I will be able to give my time, and before the exams, or like you have still 35 days to go, whenever you wish to reach out to me, I will be available. All right, so any last question? You can speak out, you can type, and we'll close it in next 1 minute. So, all right guys, so here is the last thing. So I provided our contact address, contact@dadami.com, okay? And at the same time, this is the first session from Dadami about exam fear and anxiety. And like I can make myself available for a couple of more sessions before the exams. So here is the thing which I want to listen from you, or to which you can respond by voice, or you can type yes or no. So do you want more such sessions in next 1 week, next few days, next 1 month time, so that I can have at least couple of sessions and I will book my schedule accordingly? Say yes or no. So accordingly, I will plan it out for you people. You can say yes, no, you can unmute yourself. Okay, so I have got couple of reply. Those who are not replying, you can speak out as well. Okay, so I'm getting your replies. So don't, no problem. What we are going to do is not next Sunday. We are going to have two sessions going forward. Okay. And let me tell you the dates as well. So you can schedule yourself now itself. The next session will be on 13th of September and the 27th of September. Okay, 2 weeks from today there will be a session, and 2 weeks from 13th September there will be a session. And don't worry, though we are going to keep it for 2 hours, however initial 1 hour will be sufficient for you. And lot of these things we will cover. Apart from that, I will come with something new as well. And meanwhile you can also share a feedback to contact@dynamy.com, okay, where you can demand anything which you want to listen in the next session, any questions, or you can come on the session itself and ask the questions. And you can ask your friends as well, okay, your friends, your colleagues, whoever is preparing for it. It's a free session, it's an open session, and we want the value to reach to the as many people it can reach to. So one thing I want to tell you further, that look, this prelims exam is the most important thing right now. So as the prelims will keep coming to you, your doubts, your anxiety level is going to get up, okay. It is going to increase further, and the team dynamy.com is here to support you. Vikas is here to support you, and it's my promise that you will have an extraordinary experience and as well as an extraordinary exam which will help you to get crowned with a success in the IAS exam. All right. So I think we are done with this session, and you can leave your comment, you can demand anything else, and you can write to me, you can connect with me. I will be able to schedule myself to have a one-on-one call as well with you, okay, and free to be with us whenever you need us. Thank you. You can leave the session.